Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another Pledge interview here on ITV Networks during this blessed month of Ramadan. Once again, the month of mercy, forgiveness, emancipation from the fire of Jahannam, and the month where we are all encouraged to be amongst those that give not only of our time, but also give towards causes that will enable us to receive thawab-e jariya. And this thawab-e jariya is a reward that is a perpetual reward, a reward that we will see in this world, qabr, and in the year after. And it's all about giving and talking about giving back to the communities and helping and assisting people, and not only people, but also the orphans amongst those people is Penny Appeal South Africa. We are joined by the CEO of the organization, Sister Shanaz Parak. We say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to you, sister, and jazakallah for joining us.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. It's indeed a pleasure to be here once again.
Alhamdulillah. Many of the persons or viewers out there know Penny Appeal South Africa from last year's pledge. A brief history of Penny Appeal South Africa.
Last year was our first year of operation within South Africa, and we were quite excited to be on the appeal line. Alhamdulillah, it did fantastically well, and we were really grateful to all of our donors. Since then, it's really been a whirl of activity. I'm happy to report that we've really embarked on quite a few community empowerment projects, a lot focusing in terms of education, feeding, health, orphans and vulnerable children, water projects, and the list goes on, inshallah. Quite a lot of, I think, headway has been made in terms of establishing the South African office, growing the volunteer base, ensuring that people know what we're doing, and basically getting the communication out there in terms of what Penny Appeal actually stands for, and that small change, big difference.
Alhamdulillah. Talking about small change, big difference, if we just go a little bit more back, we're talking Penny Appeal South Africa, then is this a branch of Penny Appeal worldwide?
Indeed. So it also, this year happens to be Penny Appeal Worldwide's 10th anniversary. So we're quite happy to be our second year of operation in South Africa with our head office celebrating the 10th anniversary. The family has expanded to open offices in Canada, being the most recent to come on board, as well as Dubai, Australia, USA, and inshallah, we're hoping to target a few more countries. So I think for being 10 years old, it's been a really busy 10 years for the family globally. In those 10 years, we've seen quite a few accomplishments, but I think more importantly, we've seen quite a lot in terms of Penny Appeal being able to spread some orange and spread the development and alhamdulillah serve the people that we strive to serve.
Talking about spreading the orange, we can see how far it's spread already here in our studios. Talking again back to small change, big difference. From last year, what difference has Penny Appeal made, South Africa made, to the people that you have received money from, the donors? What difference has it made to those people on the ground?
Income generated for the year 2018 has definitely made a huge impact right here at home in South Africa. We're happy to report that on the Education First project that we run, we've established a school in Primrose Park. It's a mobile unit that serves some 300 some odd high school students, 18 mobile containers, and that's been for a significant amount of money that's in excess of 4 million at least. We've also managed to strengthen our breakfast club program. That's where we provide hot breakfast meals to children in certain schools. That's grown quite intensively as well. And in keeping with feeding, which we feel is the most basic human dignity, our project Feed Our World has expanded to not only provide food hampers and hot meals, we've actually expanded it now into urban farming projects, creating sustainable livelihoods like co-ops with food gardens. Over and above that, we've embarked on 6 water wells in the Zimbabwe area, and it's the first project of its kind to expand out of South Africa into the SADC area. More so, we've attended to disasters that have taken place. Last year, it was the Khayelitsha fires. Most recently now, the KZN floods. So alhamdulillah, I think domestically, there's been a lot of growth in terms of developing that domestic footprint. and ensuring that donors' funds are utilized where most needed.
Talking about the domestic footprint, we always talk about sweep your own doorstep before you're sweeping others.
Indeed.
And that is something that Penny Appeal South Africa hopes to achieve by helping the communities that we live in. And talking also from the projects that you've run, I see education is a core focus of a Penny Appeal. Do you want to tell our viewers why?
Most definitely. I think, coming back to working at home or closer to home, at Penny Appeal, we like to say that we're confidently South African and proudly Muslim. Mm. That's the ethos we like to adopt in all of our work. So home ground is definitely first for us. Education, we prioritize it, more importantly so because it's dealing with the youth. And we know in any sector, the youth are the future of tomorrow. So while there's lots we can do to assist adults in terms of empowerment, small business starts, for an example, last year we ran a female empowerment workshop where we awarded business grants to 30-some-odd females in the larger KZN and surrounding provinces. We come back to the youth always, because if you invest in the youth, clearly that is a means to ensure that our future is a lot more sustainable, that it gives them a brighter future and a chance to empower their communities when they go back. Mm. So in keeping with that, I think our focus is not only education, it's a lot to do with the youth as well, with children, with investing not only money, but time, investing ethos and values into the children and communities we serve. You know, when we do, example, a water project or an education project, it doesn't just stop at that. You know, if it's a water project, we ensure that the community learns about hygiene and sanitation, that there's courses run about that to empower them, to impart knowledge. When it's about education, we take an avid interest in the activities of the learners. What are they doing? How are they progressing? If it's, example, our orphan sponsorships, we take an avid interest in ensuring that all of the corners of their lives are taken care of, that they're able to access medical, that they're able to access educational support if required. And all of this, we believe, is required, because ultimately it does take a village to raise a child. And so we like to consider the Penny Appeal family being the village and all our donors part of it. And inshallah, it's to pave the way to a brighter future.
Inshallah. Don't forget Penny Appeal's live pledge line taking place later. You can call in and pledge your support, inshallah. Talking about investing, we just heard when it is the month of Ramadan, the month of giving, our rewards are increased by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Coming back then to the youth, Sister Shanaz, you make mention that the youth is also a primary focus of Penny Appeal South Africa. How then do we get the youth involved, especially in projects for the Penny Appeal?
So it's twofold when we look at youth empowerment. Aside from the empowerment projects that we do and the actual projects on the ground which empower communities and the youth, we also look at bringing on board other stakeholders like youth from schools, from communities which are a bit more affluent and who require participation within the charitable sector. And this is through our Team Orange volunteer component. So alhamdulillah, it's been a busy year for Team Orange as well. Last year, we managed to recruit at least, around plus or minus 100 volunteers regionally and domestically for Team Orange. And early this year, we took some of those Team Orange volunteers for the Palestine Marathon, where there was a crowdfunding event and we managed to all participate in the Palestine Marathon. So lots of growth in the volunteering sector as well. We do feel that it's a really great, lively movement, and it has the ability to offer individuals from all walks of life something to maintain their interest, something to be able to have them go out there, see what's happening in the world, make their mark, make their difference. Because ultimately, as we study, we go to school, we study, we go into the corporate world, you want a bit more. We feel it's a really great means for people to be able to do more, not just learn more, but do more, become more vested, become people and change makers in their society, and inshallah, you know, give back tenfold.
Talking about change makers, then we know Penny Appeal South Africa, first year from last year to this year. What have you seen the biggest change in those volunteers that have joined Penny Appeal South Africa?
We're finding that with the types of projects that we've been implementing, the actual philosophy or the way in which we've been implementing them is tailor-made specifically to address the needs of the community. And in doing so, we're opting to rather use newer methods, you know, methods that people haven't seen before, even the type of outreach we do. You know, whereas we would have given food packs before, we'd now opt for food vouchers to enable people to have freedom of choice. Yeah. For our Eat Dream campaign, which we ran last year, as opposed to handing out cash or defining what the child gets, we've now opted to use gift cards. In the case of, for an example, emergency situations and shack fires, we actually worked with a research paper at the University of Cape Town, which enabled us to install little mechanisms into each shack in an informal settlement in Cape Town. So when there's a shack fire, it'll actually alert all of those around them. And it's resilience building. So again, something new. You know, you're being progressive. You're not actually looking for disasters to happen. You're being proactive in terms of the approach.
So it's a progressive orange penny appeal, South
Africa. I would say progressive. I'd say orange. I would say, you know, really putting fun in and combining elements of fun ways to raise funds, to do projects with communities, and merging that with different types of stakeholders in communities.
We go for a short break. That's how we can get involved with Penny of Peel, South Africa. Inshallah, when we come back, we listen from Sister Shanaz Paraku, who is the CEO of Penny of Peel, South Africa, as to why we should be getting involved in joining Penny of Peel, South Africa and earning Thawab Yajaria. We'll hear more about the pledge coming on later, live on ITV Networks. And inshallah, do call in and pledge your support to Orange Penny of Peel, South Africa. Keep watching.